Hi again, everyone. Mike Conrad here, founder of Aqueous Technologies and host of the Reliability Matters podcast with you once again for more tips and tricks for cleaning circuit assemblies. On this episode, we're going to discuss voiding under bottom terminated components. Voiding, you say? I thought this was a tips and tricks for cleaning episode. Well, it is. Did you know solder voids cause excessive residues to be trapped under bottom terminated components? We'll discuss this in more detail when I return in just a moment. Solder voiding is a real issue when reflowing bottom terminated components, or BTCs. But how does that lead to increased residues? Well, the term voiding can be misleading. The definition of a void is an empty space or emptiness. When we refer to solder voids, while it is void of solder, it's frequently not an empty space. Often the so-called void is filled with flux and flux activators that, under normal reflow process conditions, should have been burned off and allowed to outgas from under the BTC. Unfortunately, as with so many instances of BTCs, the flux and its activators become trapped under the BTC, preventing solder from flowing completely under the component and trapping flux, which is prevented from outgassing due to the high volume of solder blocking its exit from below the component. Voiding and flux entrapment go hand in hand. The industry has accepted voiding. IPC allows up to 30% voiding under BGAs. BTCs, like QFNs, are more problematic as their voids entrap higher volumes of flux under the component. This is not an issue if the assembly is going to be subjected to a cleaning process, because modern cleaning machines and chemicals routinely clean under BTCs. But what if the assembler reflows with no clean flux and chooses not to clean the assembly? In all likelihood, there will be flux entrapped beneath the bottom terminated components within the void areas and outside of the ground pad and solder terminations. But the flux is no clean and is supposed to be harmless, right? Not necessarily. No clean flux technology relies on the activators within the flux to be burned off. The remaining activators and other bad actors would normally be encapsulated within a resin-rosin layer and rendered harmless due to the fact that they are encapsulated and unable to mix with moisture to produce an electrochemical migration event. Fluxes trapped under BTCs are unable to properly and thoroughly outgas and remain intact under the component. Intact activated flux chemical components are problematic and can lead to ECM-related failures. So how does one know if there are dangerous levels of non-activated flux residues under the bottom terminated components? I would recommend SIR, surface insulation resistance testing. While SIR testing does not test your production assemblies, a test board may be produced with dummy components and soldering materials and reflow profiles similar to the production ones. SIR testing of the test board should be conducted under heat and humidity conditions to simulate operation in real-life environments. If, after an established period of time, the test board does not produce a failure while under heat and humidity conditions, one may safely assume the production assembly will be okay. So, if your product has a specific expected level of reliability and product failure is not an option, either subject your process to SIR testing, as I described, and as required under IPC J Standard 001H, or, in an abundance of caution, clean your assemblies. I hope you found this topic helpful. Keep your questions and topic suggestions coming. Send them right down here to my email address. And be sure to listen to the Reliability Matters podcast. Check out more than 55 episodes on Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Spotify, and virtually wherever you get your podcasts. Be sure to subscribe to the podcast and to receive new episode notifications. We release new episodes on the second and fourth Tuesday of each month. Also, mark your calendars. All three California SMTA chapters are presenting the SMTA California Technology Day on December 8th. This is a three-hour virtual event featuring, among other things, three technical presentations covering X-ray, solder paste printing of fine pitch components, and an in-depth presentation about the relationship between reflow temperatures and contamination. Very interesting presentations. You can register for this free event on smta.org. Just navigate to the event section and scroll down to December 8th. Thanks again for watching. Stay safe, stay healthy, stay happy, and I'll see you again very soon.